friends, welcome to Easy and Homestyle Cooking. I'm Mrs. Ragini. Today I want to share a recipe which I make it regularly. This is nothing but brinjal and potato curry, and this is very, very simple to make it. I know you all might have been, you know, made it, but this is a different variation. You might have made a different variation. So this is very simple and very, very tasty. And I'm going to add little bit of tomatoes and make it little bit, you know, gravy type, not too gravy, little bit gravy. So first we are going to add some oil in a pan. I'm just using today lot of brinjal and potato, so I'm adding little bit extra oil. If you want, you can give little bit tempering, but I don't like to add tempering, so I'm adding direct onions, finely chopped onions. Just saute it, add some salt. And we are not going to cook this onions till they are soft, because anyway we are going to add potatoes, brinjal, so this will cook along with that. You can see the onions are little bit transparent. That's it. Now we are going to add some ginger garlic paste and turmeric and also curry leaves. Just saute it nicely. Once your ginger garlic paste raw flavor is gone, we are going to add in this brinjal and potato. What I did is I have cut the potatoes, I removed the skin and I have cut it into nice cubes. If you want, you can cut it into smaller pieces also. This we are going to add into our onion mixture. Mix it nicely, and also we are going to add the brinjal. Even brinjal, if you see, I have cut into big pieces. Why I cut into little bit big pieces? Because I want both the ingredients to cook at the same time. Otherwise your brinjal will cook fast and your potato won't cook. So just mix it once you add the brinjal. And now we are going to add the spices, chili powder and some cumin powder and some coriander powder, and also salt. We added initially very less, and we are going to cover this with a lid, and we are going to cook till it is 60%. Then we are going to add tomatoes. Otherwise, if you add the tomatoes now, your brinjal will cook but your potatoes won't cook. So you can just add later on, because tomatoes cooks very fast. Now I'm going to cover this with a lid. So dear friends, after slow cooking for 5 minutes, you can, you know, check in between and you can keep mixing. And if you want, you can add little bit water also. So here you can see little bit water has oozed out, and now we are going to add some more of water. And you can see the brinjal is slightly cooked, and even the potato is, see, 60% cooked. So we are going to cook for another 40%. We are going to cook for another 20%, that is another 2 to 3 minutes. And then we are going to add the tomatoes and some dry grated coconut or dry powder of coconut you can add. So after 2 minutes, I'm going to add those. So dear friends, after 2 minutes, just remove the lid, and now you can see it's nicely cooking. Now we are going to add the tomatoes. You can just take 3 big tomatoes. I love this curry when it is little bit sourness. So add more of tomatoes, that too desi tomatoes, then only you will get an excellent taste. I think I can add some more of water, and we are going to add some coconut powder, dry coconut powder, and also some garam masala. Just mix it nicely. And just check the taste. The brinjal is cooked and even the potato is cooked. Another 2 minutes, then the dish is done. I'm going to just check once the taste. I can add salt and nice garam masala flavor in the last I added. So we are going to cook for another 2 minutes, and that's it. Dear friends, this dish is now ready. You can just check, see. Nice gravy. As I told you, this you can have it with rice or even roti or pulka. In the last, we are going to add some coriander, finely chopped, and just switch off the flame. That's it. If you see, all the ingredients have cooked perfectly. So when I make like this gravy, I love to have with rice. So this, I'm going to have it with rice. But before that, I'm going to just have one brinjal piece. And whenever I make brinjal curries, I love to keep this stock like this, so that I love to eat this part. Nice and hot, simply super and tasty. So dear friends, I hope you enjoyed this very simple brinjal and potato curry. See you in another session with some more recipes, but make this